Sex is everywhere. It's in the news, in the YouTube videos you watch, and practically every television show or movie you've ever seen. But what happens if you never have sex? Would you explode? Would you die? The answer might surprise you. Even if you don't know what you're missing, your body does. It's important to remember that everyone is unique and everyone's body will react in different ways. But let's look at some common physical and mental side effects of never having sex. First, we'll look at the physical ramifications to the body if someone never has sex. There are a lot of misconceptions about what'll happen to your body from lack of sex, which we'll debunk later. But the truth may be even scarier. Men who have regular sex and ejaculate more frequently have a lower risk of prostate cancer. This means if you never have sex as a male, you're actually at a higher risk of getting prostate cancer. The reason for this is because humans evolved, like all living things on this planet, to be reproduction machines. Whether you like sex or not, your body's main purpose is to reproduce, because that's how all living things evolved. The body needs to release old sperm in order to create newer, more viable sperm. Just like with other equipment, if the male genitalia is not frequently used, there can be problems or a breakdown in the system. It's not yet clear what the precise cause of prostate cancer is, but studies suggest that men who have frequent sex or ejaculations tend to have a lower risk. So if a male never has sex, he should be at least masturbating. This will be a common theme here, because some of the benefits of sex can also be obtained from self-release, but not all. Either way, if you're a male who never has sex, you should consider doing regular prostate checks. For females that never have sex, there are different repercussions to the body. Sex strengthens the pelvic floor muscles that support the bladder. If a female never has sex, they may find themselves with a weak bladder. This could lead to leakage or incontinence. Sex is a physical activity, and the muscles involved need a workout every now and then. If you never have sex, these muscles aren't exercised, which leads to them becoming weaker. Turns out that if females are not strengthening the muscles used during sex, it can lead to negative effects on other body systems. That being said, females can also achieve the benefits of sex from self-pleasure as well. It turns out that in humans, just simulating the act of sex can trick the body into providing many of the benefits associated with the act. Another negative effect women who never have sex may encounter is that the vagina may be drier than someone who is engaged in sexual activity. This is not necessarily a problem, other than it can be uncomfortable. So if a female has never had sex and feels discomfort in her genitalia, it may be because of a lack of lubrication around the muscles and organs. Again, this problem can be solved by masturbating. At some point in their life, someone who has never had sex may want to engage in the activity. If this is the case, the lack of sex in previous years may hinder the carnal act. If someone has gone their whole life without having sex, it could take longer than expected for arousal to begin. This could happen because the body would be feeling all new sensations, and since they would be different than anything felt before, it could take a while for the necessary fluids to flow. This seems counterintuitive, since you would expect someone's body who has never had sex to be raring to go. However, the longer someone goes without ever having sex, the longer it takes for the body to prepare for the activity. Your body needs to create and dump hormones into the bloodstream, and then increase the blood flow to areas of the body that have never or very infrequently been used. This can take a while, especially for someone who has never had sex before. Whether someone is male or female, never having intercourse can be connected to higher blood pressure. There are several studies that show people who have regular sex tend to have lower blood pressure. Therefore, the opposite can also be true. Someone who has never had sex may have higher blood pressure than if they did have coitus. The most likely reason for this is because there is a correlation between having sex and the lowering of stress hormones in the body. If a person never has sex, those same stress hormones will be higher. Someone who has more stress tends to have higher blood pressure. This is a serious health concern a celibate person should be aware of. They should absolutely find other ways to lower their stress levels and blood pressure. Like we've said before, this can be done through masturbation, but there are other options as well, such as meditation. Again, our bodies evolved to be sex machines, therefore they expect to have a release every now and then. High blood pressure would definitely be a negative side effect of never having sex, but there is something else that sex might help your body with that you weren't even aware of. Having sex, or more specifically having orgasms, has been linked to benefits to someone's immune system. Psychologists Carl Czarnecki and Francis Brennan Jr. conducted a study where they took saliva samples from people who frequently had sex and those who did not, and found some surprising results. In the patients who were having sex, their saliva contained higher concentrations of immunoglobulin A, which is an antibody used to fight off the common cold. Therefore, there may be health benefits to the immune system of someone who is having sex. If this is true, then someone who has never had sex may find themselves getting sick more frequently than others. The reason for this boost in the immune system may have more to do with the close proximity to another human during sex than the act itself. So, unfortunately, this boost to your immune system may not be something you can get from masturbation, since it's only a party of one. So it would seem that never having sex may have negative physical effects on the body, but what about the mental effects? Are the people who never have sex at risk of having higher mental health issues? Since everyone is different, there is no absolute definitive answer, but someone who has never had sex may be at a higher risk of certain negative mental health issues. As we've said before, the act of having sex releases certain hormones that lower stress levels in the body. This can be achieved through masturbation as well, but another important mental health benefit of sex is the feeling associated with physical intimacy, something that cannot be obtained through self-pleasure. Someone who has never had sex before may develop what psychologists call skin hunger or touch starvation. This is when lack of close physical contact results in negative mental health issues. The intimacy during sex cannot be replicated even if someone spends a lot of time around other people. The physical contact and sensations during sex are sometimes necessary. If someone has never had sex, it could cause their body to react negatively to the lack of intimacy. It would not be surprising for someone who has never had sex to feel isolated or insecure. This could be caused by an imbalance in hormones in the body due to a lack of sexual contact. The change in chemical composition of the body from sex is not just because it feels good or pleasurable, but because it's something intimate and shared between individuals. If someone who has never had sex is feeling depressed or lonely, even if they're surrounded by others, it could be because their brain is craving intimacy. In these cases, we only have evolution to blame yet again. Our DNA is selfish and wants to be passed on to the next generation. Therefore, almost all of us are programmed to want to have sex. One way our body tricks us into copulating is by rewarding us not just with pleasurable physical sensations, but with mental stimulation as well. The brain of someone who has never had sex could be starved for intimacy of it. This, in turn, could cause negative side effects to mental health. So really, for someone who has never had sex, their brain begins to rebel against them. When your brain is fighting you, it's going to be a bad time. However, as mentioned before, everyone is different. Some people actually don't need to have sex at all and are still healthy and happy. This can be because of a low sex drive or that the person is asexual. The human brain is a magnificent thing and can even overcome our biological urges in some people. In others, the brain may be programmed to just not crave sex, and for these individuals, never having sex most likely comes with no side effects. There are misconceptions based around what happens to someone who has never had sex. So let's break them down. Someone may have told you that if a female doesn't have sex, their vagina closes up. Not only is this untrue, but think of how many other complications that would cause for that person other than not being able to have intercourse. A female who has never had sex will most likely have a smaller opening to the vagina than females who are more sexually active, but there's absolutely zero chance the vagina will completely close up. Even females who have never had sex still produce sex hormones, which means that although there may be discomfort or negative side effects from not having sex, they are still able to do so at any point during their life. What it comes down to is that everybody's body is different. Some people may choose to never have sex and can still lead a long and happy life. They may have to find other ways to mitigate some of the negative side effects, such as lack of intimacy, but it can be done. We know masturbation can produce many of the positive benefits of having sex. There are some risks to never having sex, such as a greater chance of prostate cancer in men and incontinence in women, but we live in a time where there are medical options to combat these negative side effects. What'll happen to your body if you never have sex? It just depends on who you are. But for most of us, we'll feel discomfort, mostly in the genitalia, and we'll probably feel lonely or more stressed even if we are around other people. Sex is literally in our DNA, so although it may not be necessary, it could be hard to avoid. Now, check out what is persistent genital arousal disorder. Sex disorder explained. Or watch what exactly is an orgasm.